Hi, I'm Shaka Hislop and you're here at Extra Time TV.
Up next, Juventus take on Ajax. The first game was very exciting. Ajax played some wonderful football, but unfortunately they came away with a 1-1 draw. They created lots and lots of chances, and the man of the hour, many people were questioning if he should have played, Cristiano Ronaldo, was carrying an injury, but he proved to be a savior for Juventus. Ajax, once again, finishing being their downfall. They created lots and lots of chances. They actually probably could have won easily by, you know, 2 or 3 goals, but finishing let them down once more. And Juventus, in typical Juventus fashion, got that crucial goal, which gave them a result that could have easily been a loss. That goal is a crucial away goal. And Cristiano Ronaldo, who was signed for the primary reason of doing well in the Champions League, is doing his job. A lot of people criticized Allegri for using Ronaldo because, and I can understand why, you have an injured player, he is your star man, essentially he's the Leo Messi for that team. And if he's injured, and possibly could be injured for the rest of the season, how can you possibly justify Cristiano Ronaldo playing when Juventus by itself are a powerful team? They are not Ronaldo reliant, they have lots of quality players, and they should be able to do the job. With that being said, Ajax are continuing to woo fans with their wonderful high-energy possession football. We saw what they did to Real Madrid, and 1-1 is not so bad. Remember, they lost their first game to Real Madrid and thrashed them at home. Real Madrid didn't see that coming. Now, with that being said, Real Madrid has their problems. They are not as defensively sound as Juventus, but Juventus haven't been exactly watertight this season. Chiellini and those boys are not exactly young, you know, pops anymore. They are definitely getting up there in age, and they have shown the tendency to have moments of, you know, dips in concentration. But Juventus are known for their character and grinding out results and winning in an ugly fashion. Depends on what you like. And, you know, I personally like what they do. I like the style they play, but I think this is definitely going to be interesting because with Juventus at home, Ajax doesn't seem to fear anyone, and nor should they. And I think if they continue to play that style of football, it's not going to be a Real Madrid, you know, I think it was 4-0, but I think it's definitely going to cause Juventus some problems, these young, dynamic players. In the last game, the possession, it was 61% to Ajax, with Juventus having a measly 39%, with one shot on target. One shot on target, and that says a lot about Juventus. But it also highlights the stereotype that often, you know, plagues Italian football. You know, they play that defensive style of football, but I think they had no choice because of the style of Ajax and how they are playing. Ajax head into this game with nothing to fear. I think the pressure is actually more on Juventus, as bizarre as that sounds, because nobody expected Ajax to get this far. It's a young, exciting team. Tadic is a player that I really admire, and I think, you know, with guys, In our previous previews, I even mentioned, you know, players like Huntelaar would be important, but it seems like these guys are doing the job, but they have to take their chances. If they do not take their chances, you know, a team like Juventus is a bit more ruthless compared to Real Madrid right now, and, you know, they may get one chance and just bury the tie. So Ajax has to take their chances. It sounds like a copy and paste of what Kevon and I said for the last match day, but I actually fancy Ajax to go to Juventus in Turin and basically grab a crucial away goal, which may send Juventus packing. I really think so. I think Juventus are not, you know, the best team, or not the same team they were 2-3 years ago. I think they're playing on a lot of character. I think they have the potential to get really far, but Ajax has the psychological freedom because, as Marcelo Bielsa said many years ago, you know, being favorites adds a psychological weight to one and takes it away from the other. And I think that's what's going to happen. These guys have nothing to fear, and I honestly believe that that's going to help them play the way they need to play. If they do not score, it easily could be a dominant Ajax team that gets their heart broken from Juventus. So with that being said,
yo.
Yes,
the score.
Once again, my cameraman is not letting me escape the predictions. So I'm not going to sit on a fence because it's a very painful place to sit. I'm going to play devil's advocate and say Ajax are going to get that crucial away goal and send Juventus packing and Ronaldo. I think that Atletico Madrid game was bizarre to say the least. I think I'm not sure what happened. Juventus came back, yes, but I think, and kudos to them, but I think Ajax based on what I've seen in the first game, I'm going to go to the next round. So let me know what you think in the comment section below. What do you think Ajax needs to do? What do you think Juventus needs to do? Do you agree? Do you disagree? That's the wonderful thing about football. Each person could look at this beautiful game and interpret it completely differently from the other person. So according to our polls, Juventus have a 75% chance of going through. 25% of our voters said Ajax. Let us know what you think by voting in our Twitter and Facebook polls, which will be placed in the description below. These polls will be open up until the actual match day. So you have all the time in the world, well, up until the actual match days, to vote. And also comment in the comment section, because when you do that, you automatically qualify for a chance to win a copy of FIFA 19. And speaking about FIFA 19, I'd like to say a special congratulations to Trev. He won a copy of FIFA 19. Congratulations to you, son. Congratulations. That's my coach voice. Also, be sure to check out our episode with ESPN FC's Shaka Hislop, where we speak about a lot of topics, specifically in the CONCACAF region. Be sure to check it out. Shaka Hislop is the man. ESPN FC, EXTV, the ultimate combo.
Hi, I'm Shaka Hislop, and you're here at Extra Time TV.
Ronaldo decision validated. He came through unscathed.
It's always, always good fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to check out more, look at this video. And don't forget to click the subscribe button, because when you do, one of your enemies will be destroyed.